Welcome viewers to the second part of the final episode of season 1 of the Manu Sharma Show. Our guest tonight is the owner of agribusiness Holland Door, which offers study tours, trainings, matchmaking services for Dutch and Indians. Welcome to the Manu Sharma Show, Mr. Nick Bodden.
First of all, thank you for having me here. It's a great honor to be in your show.
Could you tell us a little bit about yourself and what was your affiliation with India?
I'm Nick Bodden, 41 years old. I'm a son of a greenhouse farmer, born in the southeast of the Netherlands, in a very small, I would say, basically farmer village called Welleloy. I got infected, I would say, with the Horti disease.
Okay.
And still runs in my veins.
How did your entrepreneurial journey begin in horticulture?
I would say the real entrepreneurial spirit started when I was still a kid, a youngster, I would say. When I was working as a hobby on my father's company, we had cauliflower outside,
okay,
which we sold to private people in small supermarkets, etc. My father grew cauliflower, large scale. Mm-hmm. I grew cauliflower on a small scale.
Oh, wow.
And every 2 weeks, we did the same. So my cauliflower was then also sold to the supermarket. When I was 16 years old, I went to the Greenhouse Research Institute from the government. That gave me a lot of experience for a lot of vegetable, flower, pot plant crops. And then went to Wageningen, got my university degree. After working for about 2 years for the university, I graduated in 2001 and I started my first company, I think official company, in 2003. Went well 4 or 5 years, then I was so much involved in the daily strategies mm-hmm. of my client's company mm-hmm. that I said on a certain point, I know now more than 95% of your own employees.
Okay.
I was a big flower breeder. I said, we do one thing, or you buy our company, mm-hmm. my company, or it's better that I leave you because it didn't work anymore. I mentioned that on a piece of paper.
I see.
I put it in the keyboard of the CEO of a big breeding company.
Okay.
And on the morning, there was an answer on it and said, okay.
Okay.
And then my company was sold. I worked 3 years over there. Mm-hmm. Then I started working for myself again. One is that I have my own consultancy company where I do a lot of research and consultancy. Nowadays, it's more about services, developing new business services where people, mainly farmers, can take an abonnement. The second one, and that is really the bridging, called Holland Door.
What were the biggest challenges you overcame when establishing three ventures?
I sold my own company mm-hmm. in 2008. Secondly, it was in 2012. Mm-hmm. where also Holland Door was one of my companies. In mm-hmm. this kind of business, we found out what we need is first people with a huge network in mm-hmm. Netherlands, mm-hmm. but especially also network international. Secondly, people who can really work on their own, self-supporting, self-servicing. Mm-hmm. And third, yeah, people who really know to glue different ties mm-hmm. and angles together. Where to find these employees, mm-hmm. it's difficult. Somehow they started to work for themselves mm-hmm. because they think or they find or they experience that they can exploit better their own expertise by being alone than being on a payroll somewhere. So that's actually how we glued Holland Door together.
How did you realize the center of excellence?
First of all, it was not realized by me. Many years ago, the Indian government signed together with the Dutch government a joint action plan. Mm-hmm. We look to India as a country where all these people need food. Mm-hmm. Secondly, the wealth of the people is increasing. Diets are changing. Mm-hmm. So that puts a lot of pressure on the country's agricultural performance. Mm-hmm. The Indian government sees that very clearly. Where the amount of fresh water more scarce because more people, changing climates, etc. The price for fertilizer, energy, even labor are increasing. Mm-hmm. That means for India a lot of challenges
yes.
to increase the performance and also the efficiency in agriculture. Mm-hmm. Indian government looked around in the world, I would say, and found out the Netherlands is one of the leading countries in agriculture.
Absolutely.
Somehow you can consider whole Holland as one city mm-hmm. where about 70 million people live. Mm-hmm. That is about a little bit less even than Greater Mumbai. Mm-hmm. But in that city, we are that efficient that we export about 85% of the production what we produce.
Yes, that is huge.
So that means that somehow we do something very efficient in production, mm-hmm. as well as in trade and in logistics.
Yes.
About 70% of the Indian population are farmers.
Yes.
The cities are growing, but to feed the people in the city and to give them the food what they want is a big challenge and journey even for India to make. So Holland can play a considerable role in that. One, by assisting farmers to optimize in their production by means of being more efficient with water, being more efficient with fertilizer, decrease the amount of chemicals.
Yes.
It's enormous chemical usage that can be decreased by introducing new technologies and know how to produce.
Yes.
You cannot simply introduce new technology or new know-how to farmers when they have been doing on generation farming principle on a certain way. It needs first awareness that there is something out there which might be interesting for Indian farmers.
Okay.
And then it's understanding.
Yes.
After acceptance, the understanding how to use that new technology.
Yes.
Now, in that pathway, the Indian and the Dutch government said, okay, let's establish so-called centers of excellence all over India, where basically Dutch technology is adapted to Indian context and introduced to Indian farmers that they can see how Indian farming 2.0 can look alike.
Okay.
It is not from here to the high tech, highest tech as possible, it's intermediate solution, but it is still that challenging that not all the farmers can reach that point.
Okay.
That they don't have the entrepreneurial skills for that or not access to capital or information.
Yes.
So we try to take only the leading farmers the step forward, and we believe when the leading farmers are making that step forward, that in that slope, rest of the farming community will follow.
Lift,
yes. It's like we say here in Holland, when one sheep is over the bridge, all the rest will follow. Basically, that's the idea.
Yes.
Now, the first center of excellence was opened last year in November in Baramati, which is chaired by Mr. Sharad Pawar. And in that scenery, we will be able to develop it quite fast. It's opened last year in November, and it's going quite well. A lot of people visited it and are really positive.
How is innovation being applied in the horticulture industry?
Mostly innovation is not supply-driven, but demand-driven. When there is a certain problem or a certain problem that they forecast that will come, then farmers are starting to think how to avoid that problem or to solve the problem.
Okay.
And that is basically the innovation in technology. It can be also an innovation in know-how development, etc. It's not always technology. We are quite unique in the world how we tackle problems in the sector. We bring together all the different stakeholders from different angles. So that can be farmers, can be supplying companies, can be research institutes, can be government, can be NGOs, who have interest in that innovation or in that problem which is there, to solve it together. It is how we do it here in Holland, but somehow it is working. It brought us till this point in the world, I think, where we were one of the leading countries.
Yes.
And we try now a little bit to introduce that model as well in India. We have now a new project where in the coming 3 years we are going to train a group of trainers, who are basically disseminating this new knowledge and technology to Indian farmers. We are not going to train only trainers who are now employed by government institutes. No, we are going to invite also private companies to bring again together that multi-stakeholder role in one group. Because that we believe it's really the model to bring Indian agriculture a step forward.
Recently, you trained 40 Indian farmers from Madhya Pradesh. Could you elaborate on that?
First of all, they were not trained by me. It was a study tour. But this is a typical request from an Indian group. So farmers or supported by the government, interested to come to Holland for a couple of days, 1 week, 1.5 week, to look around in different sectors. So that can be dairy, can be horticulture, can be open field farming. To different teams, to new technology, but also to the know-how. So that links again to the previous question, where we can try to bring all the technology and information to India.
Yes.
Sometimes it's better to bring the people, to not bring the kitchen to India, no, bring the people towards the kitchen.
Yes.
So we receive these study groups, but we received also other groups from also private companies who are interested, who dedicated study tours. Okay. Basically, we see a lot of requests, not only from the leading provinces and states in India, but all over, okay, from the basic south to the up north. And each individual has their own unique conditions, mm-hmm, back home, but also unique questions in support they need,
okay,
and demand what they want to find out over here.
In your opinion, where do you see the horticulture industry headed to in the next 5 years?
Well, what I see in India is the population in the cities is growing very fast.
Mm-hmm.
So that means there's a big demand coming from the cities. Now that offers a lot of questions for the coming decades. How to feed the Delhis, the Mumbais, the Bangalores, etc. Where it is not easy to bring in all the food from the countryside towards the cities,
mm-hmm,
with the infrastructure. Traffic jams are there.
Very bad.
Very bad. Unfortunately, I experienced also a couple of very bad ones.
Mm-hmm.
But on the same moment, how to move the food,
yes,
from the countryside towards the city.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you can do a lot in the night,
mm-hmm,
but you cannot do everything in the night.
No.
So it opens up new challenges for India, how to produce food, I would say, on the countryside, around the city, according to demand from the cities.
Mm-hmm.
But also, it opens the potential of city farming and vertical farming.
Okay.
In some areas where you say, okay, the people are willing to pay for food,
mm-hmm,
then it is possible to produce also food in the city. I think it will be in India a combination of different production systems,
mm-hmm,
where the majority will definitely still come from the countryside, where they move up with new technology, new know-how, but also new supply chain concepts combined near the city up to maybe rooftop farming or in-building farming or in the basement farming.
Wow.
Because nowadays we can grow with technology plants,
mm-hmm,
where the sunlight is not there anymore. You can do it completely internally.
Yes.
That is my vision for the coming 5, 10, 25 years,
okay,
because it will not happen overnight.
Thank you very much, Mr. Nick Borden, for sharing your journey on our show tonight.
Thank you.
Wishing you all the best.
Thanks a lot.
This marks the end of season 1. If you enjoyed our show, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel. We will be back with bigger and even better season 2. Till that time, take care and keep watching The Manu Sharma Show.